Fred, you got on a blindfold?
Absolutely.
Jackie?
What?
You got a blindfold on?
Here.
And what about you, Robin? You
got I have my blindfold on.
Just the mystery.
I hope it isn't somebody I said bad stuff about in the past. And, all right, I'll go first.
All right.
Did I ever say anything bad about you on the radio now? It's going to be real uncomfortable when I take the blindfold off.
But of course you have.
Hmm.
What
sounds like my father.
Voice?
Wow.
But of course you have.
Hmm.
Are you doing an impression of my father?
No, I'm not.
Huh.
He sounds like a young guy.
Well, you've gotten
a no now.
It's time for me.
No, I... Oh, yeah, okay, that's a no. Okay, Robin, your turn.
All right, are you in the world of movies?
He's in this world.
Yes, of course I am. Otherwise, I would not be here.
Okay.
But Mystery Guest is predominantly known right now for another medium.
Oh, would that be television?
Hey, wait a second.
That was a yes!
All right, go ahead.
That was a leading.
You were leading the witness.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I'm questioning here.
I'm questioning.
I hope it's O.J.
Oh, no.
He can't get out. Would that be television?
You're a very bright person.
You
a
are a television
series?
Person.
Pardon me?
A current series.
Yes, but of course I am. Otherwise, I would not be here.
He's not a loser.
All right. That's three yeses. It's a series.
Ask him if he's promoting his television show.
Are you promoting your TV show?
No, I am not promoting
you,
my television
that
show.
That was Howard's question.
Sorry. Okay, I'll let Jackie Martling go next.
Jackie Martling.
Is it a comedy show?
Is it a comedy show?
What other kind of show is there?
So that's a yes. Go ahead, Jackie.
Of course.
Are you the main star?
I would guess so. Yes, of course.
Huh.
Hmm. Studley Moore.
No. Go, Fred.
You must now leave the room.
I'm going to take a wild guess. Tim Allen?
Is
that
it?
That is correct.
That is correct.
Wow. I knew who it was.
Hey, big star, Tim Allen.
I was going to say, is it the number one show?
Wow, hey, nice to see you.
Nice to see you, sir.
Oh, let me suck you in for a second. Now, Tim, let me ask you something.
That was really cheesy. I mean, I come in here with, I do my Brian Brunschweiger voice. Nobody knows. It's so good.
I think you sounded like my father, because my father talks like this. You must have proper modulation. If you do not have the proper modulation...
I will slap you.
Yes, I will slap you if you do not have the proper modulation.
What did your dad call you in your book? Now, this is a while back that I read it.
He called me a moron.
You're a little moron. What are you? Quiet, you little moron.
My father's line would be...
Shut up, you moron.
No, he'd say, I told you not to be stupid, you idiot. And I'd say, wait a second. If I'm stupid, how could you tell an idiot not to be stupid? But anyway. All right, let me ask you a couple of questions. First of all, I'm reading the paper today, and it says that Tim Allen is the number two most liked man in America.
Number two? Who's number one?
O.J.
Jackie Martin.
O.J. I mean, how does that make you feel? I mean, seriously, you were a stand-up comic. You weren't very well known, right?
Not very good, according to your book.
I never even saw you. I just said that.
You had a pretty good book, right? I mean, real good book.
I think it was good.
You took a lot of shots that I wish I'd taken. You know,
right.
I read your wife didn't get you apples.
Right.
With my wife in the limousine on the way over here. Says, you know, he asked one thing. Get me apples and bananas. And she goes... Why does he go out and get him? I said, let's not get into this crap. You know, I'm not going to argue
because
with you.
Because I don't have time.
That's what I said. I did the same thing.
Exactly. All right. You got a lot of interesting stuff here. You came out with a book, and yet you didn't pull a Seinfeld. You didn't sit there and rework.
You didn't write your routines down.
You wrote about your life.
Yeah.
You see, that is admirable.
Well, I took a shot, but I said, I reread your book on a plane. Somebody said, because I'd read it when you first came. I just wondered what this is all about. You took a shot, too. But I mean, you actually wrote it.
Yeah, I wrote about my life.
Yeah.
And
a lot of chances.
Yeah, right. But who cares? I'm nobody anyway. So what was the difference? I always saw myself as nobody, so I might as well take chances. Why not?
Yeah.
What chance were you taking?
Yeah, I didn't see any chance. A chance I'd sell a few books. So in other words, you opened up your life to the public. You said, I'm going to write about my feelings and this kind of thing.
Yeah.
And you're a guy who also, admirably, stuck with his wife, didn't you, when you got your fame?
Yeah.
You're married to... How long are you married?
13 years.
13 years. You're sticking with her.
Mm-hmm.
You like her.
Well, she'd kill me.
Yeah, exactly. My wife, too.
She put it, like I said in the book, she put a grenade in my pants if I screw around. You know?
But and the temptation, obviously, you work with a couple of pieces of ass on that show.
The Pamela Anderson used to be on the show as the Tool Time girl.
Yeah, that Pamela Anderson is some girl. Did you see her naked pictures?
Yes, of course. Of course I have, Mr. Bond, yes.
Now, when you work with girls like that, I know my wife is very nervous about who's going to play her in the movie because I'm going to get to do a lot of make-out and love scenes.
Why? You don't do it at home.
Get out, everybody. I'm here all week. Is that why the glass is there?
Yes. I can't throw things at her. No, you know in the beginning, I used to get a lot of love from her.
I see.
Yeah, I was a horny guy.
Yeah.
So the beginning stuff, by the time I'm older, I'm already with different girls.
Right.
All right. So you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, but...
Now, what about the temptation? When you have a Pamela Anderson, who obviously was probably into having sex with you, true?
No.
No?
She's actually a cool, cool lady.
Oh, of course.
But the problem is, it's all guys on the set, and sometimes she'd come to the set, and she just would look fabulous.
She's in short shorts and stuff.
With the ass
hanging out
right.
of the shorts.
Everything.
Right, yeah, right.
Everything hanging out. But she just happens to be the sweetest person in the world, so you can't, once you get, and I'm like that, once you like a girl, you know, you like a girl.
You can't think of her that way.
But
do you have to, can I be blunt?
Be blunt.
Do you have to masturbate?
Ah!
Yeah, constantly.
Seriously?
Hold on.
Me too. No, I'm being serious. No, I do.
When would he be masturbating? What are you asking him?
No, I'm
on
saying,
a set?
No, listen, he's been with his wife 13 years. Here's a guy I can talk to.
All right.
He got famous.
Yeah.
Never expected to have this degree of fame. True?
True.
I mean, to have the number one show on TV,
hey.
You beat Roseanne, and then they put Frasier up against you, and you're like...
Wiped him out.
And even you can't believe it, right?
No, I can't believe it.
It's unbelievable.
It's a long season.
Do you get nervous when, Frasier goes up against you, or you just go, I know I'm going to win.
Well,
my show beats everything.
I got real nervous because, as usual, they always pose us as, like, this big 300-pound gorilla. Oh, boy, Home Improvement's going to take out some erudite show that's very hip,
right,
and everybody
right.
likes it. We have the same budget he does.
Right.
The same people, nice people work on it, and that... I got real worried.
Yeah, you get scared.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you want it to last. And like Seinfeld, he thought, I am the funniest guy. I will beat Tim Allen.
I will beat Tim Allen.
And Seinfeld went up against you, and what happened?
Well,
he was.
But Frasier, unfortunately, what they're doing by putting Frasier against us, it's making Seinfeld stronger. He has no competition.
That's right.
And he's getting close.
He will rise to the top.
I think it's going to be neck and neck. Seinfeld on our show.
But how weird is it that you and do you are you superstitious? Do you feel like, oh my God, it's going to go away? It's going to go away. You're real nervous.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're like me.
I'm just, it's all done. It's all done today. I just told my wife, it's all done. We're
all done. It's over. This is it.
Did we enjoy it?
Yeah, right.
Was it fun? It's over. It's done. Let's just.
And you watch the show each week after you do it, and you go, I don't know what I did right here. Why were the ratings high this week, and what did I do right? I don't understand what's going on.
Well, I'm just trying to figure out what the country was doing. Sometimes it's huge, and sometimes it's not so huge. You go, they look, oh, it was that gambler thing with Kenny Rogers or whatever, you know.
Yeah, that did it.
So I'll have to have him killed.
That's it. He has to be executed.
I would appreciate that, actually.
Kenny Rogers must die. Well, you wrote all about your drug use and all that kind of stuff.
Yes.
Which, by the way, is a badge of honor, quite frankly, with our generation. So you're this guy who's this, you were kind of an obscure stand-up comic, true?
Well,
obscure.
He had a couple of HBO specials, okay?
Right, Showtime, right. I've been on the road. I worked here in New York at Dangerfields for quite a while.
And it's cool, you wrote all about your drug use and all that kind of stuff.
Yes.
Which, by the way, is a badge of honor, quite frankly, with our generation. Nobody
well,
looked
everybody
at it as negative.
Did that, yeah.
Yeah, but he did time.
Yeah.
That's
I know.
Like, for pot, right?
No.
Oh, coke?
Mm-hmm. Glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
So I try to kind of skate over that one.
But you deal with it in the book, don't you?
I didn't actually say.
Oh, you did say
it was cocaine?
I just said drugs.
Hey, listen, so you had a problem, that's all.
No, I wasn't a problem.
Were you doing
the problem
it yourself?
The police were the problem.
You didn't have a problem.
This is always said, that's the advice I give, just don't sell drugs to policemen.
Like many people of our generation, you got involved in drug use.
Right.
And
were we really a coke generation?
Oh, you weren't using. You were dealing.
I was dealing.
Oh, he wouldn't take it himself.
Come on.
Yeah,
you think
stupid.
I'm stupid?
What, were times bad or something?
No. It was just great.
He was an entrepreneur.
You were making money.
I was making money and it was lost. I had college. I had no idea what you're doing. You know, everybody got a degree in broadcast.
Me too. You did that too?
Yeah. What am I going to do with that?
Right. You got all freaked out.
Well, I had to get freaked out. But a couple of guys said, "Would you run this over here for me?" I go, "Well, no." It's just like the kid. Any kid that in the street that's the same attraction. Just we were on a higher level, and all of a sudden it got to be making serious money, and it got stupid.
So you mean you actually went to jail?
Prison.
With black guys?
Penitentiary. Well, yeah, that, but...
You didn't get any butt sex or anything, did you?
Well, I looked for it everywhere.
Guys weren't attracted to you?
That doesn't happen in prison?
I just wasn't a handsome...
But I mean, you went to real prison.
Yeah, with the lockup and the... It was great.
How long were you in?
3 years.
Oh, wow. Man. So then you worked on your stand-up, I guess, in prison.
Well, actually, you sit down. You don't want to stand up. Good night, everybody. I'm here all week. Try to veal.
Because you were communications, and it never occurred to you to go into stand-up out of college because you didn't know. You couldn't find yourself.
Actually, before, it was during my sentencing.
Right.
My lawyer said, I think you're going to do some time. And I said, nah, come on. I'm a white kid from a nice family. I didn't mean anything. I didn't even know what I was doing. I didn't, that whole thing.
That's a simple mistake.
Yeah. Lock up black kids. What are you doing? I'm a white guy.
He said, if you figure out something to do.
Right.
Just figure out something to do. You know, he said, do something that you'll be able to think about. So I went and did an open mic night in Detroit, where I live, and he said, and it got real good.
And then they locked you up.
While
you were waiting to do time, you started comedy.
And were your parents freaking out?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Well, now at least are your parents alive still?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So they get to see at least you're successful.
Well, they're both in jail now.
Good. You should put them in there. Oh, that's too cool.
Yeah.
Hey, sounds like a good book.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'll buy it.
Three years in the store.
Well, I thought about it when I wrote that chapter. There's so much in there that I couldn't do when I did my stand-up for years. I get up right out of jail. I tell people, I was in jail, and they go, yeah, right. If they don't buy the fact you're in there, then my stories aren't that exciting.
Well, I'll tell you the truth. When it first broke in the tabloids, I thought you were trying to give yourself an image.
Mm. Right. Well, what happened there was that at Walt Disney, when I was on the lot someday, that somebody, the scuttlebutt was, people are going to bring this up.
Mm-hmm.
I said, Christ, it was 20 years ago.
Right.
And I said, but
yeah, sure.
Well, it was 20
it doesn't matter to anybody.
It doesn't matter. All of a sudden, it seems like it was yesterday.
And that's
you
right.
Never live this down, No matter how long you do this stuff, someone's going to bring
Tim
it up.
Tim Allen just got out of jail and got a TV
20 years ago.
Hey, listen, Rock murdered a guy. He's doing fine.
Nobody right. brings that up to him, though.
No, everyone's... yeah. I'd like to interview him.
Yeah, you don't go right after, hey.
Yeah, right.
how'd you murder that guy?
Yeah, right. The point is, you get out of college, you're so confused, you don't know what to do, and you have a communications degree. They ought to outlaw communications degrees.
At least the crime.
You are prepared for nothing.
Well, actually, a liberal arts degree.
Yeah.
Now, that is like...
What is that?
What is that?
Yeah, what am I going to do? I got to deal coke.
You can converse with liberals. That's about all you can do.
Okay, let's go down memory lane for a second. Here we go. There it is. All right. Look at Timmy shaking. Oh, easy, pal.
What is that
squeal? You know what that is. Tim don't want to talk about that. He's very honest in the book, but look, the guy's a big TV star. He can't take any chances.
Oh, boy.
So, I mean, do any of your prison buddies and stuff, contact you now and go, hey, man.
Remember me?
Were you the only white guy?
No.
Did you have to join, the Aryans and stuff?
No, I was funny. Once you're funny, that's the way out of everything.
And nobody kicked your ass and stuff in prison?
No.
This was in Detroit, right?
No, I did. I went through a circuit. They put you in different prisons. They get the one you set up.
Why do they do that? They don't want you getting comfortable?
Well, I had a bunch of other rap partners, as they call them. Mm-hmm. A bunch of other guys that got arrested. They wanted to make sure we were all in different prisons.
Oh, I see. Buddies.
So they sent me up to Minnesota. Sandstone, Minnesota. Sounds like a resort, doesn't it?
But you got arrested in Detroit. And Detroit's like a prison itself. So it was you were in prison in Detroit, and then you know.
He probably lived outside of Detroit.
Well, not, yeah, I did.
Oh, did you? Where'd you live, in Southfield or something?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's where I lived.
You have friends there, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, I lived there. I was a disc jockey there for a while.
It
sucked. I hate
W4.
Detroit.
W4.
I hated Detroit. Yeah, W4.
Yeah.
Oh, worst experience of my life.
Well, good. I love it there.
Do you really? Okay, we have a lot in common. Right. We have strong loves and hates. Well, you grew up there. You're more comfortable.
Well, I grew up in Denver, actually. Moved to Detroit.
So anyway,
during the riots.
So here you are, guy at prison, and you're thinking, I'm going to be a stand-up comic.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody thinks, hey, who's this guy? He's completely insane. No sex for 3 years. Could you have visitation?
Yeah, but that was the worst thing in the world. My wife would get there, and you go through these little hot...
You were married?
Uh-huh. You got to be faithful to your wife.
But we knew each other then.
You got to be faithful to your wife, man. If she...
She visited you in prison.
Well, yeah. She waited for me.
Hey, your wife is here?
Mm-hmm.
Could she come in?
I don't think she wants to.
She doesn't? She's too nervous?
She doesn't like getting in the... I don't like her around this business, you know?
Yeah, but, hey, that's how I am
that's
with my
exactly
wife.
That's exactly how you are.
Yeah, I don't want my wife in a room. She once came to Letterman with me, and I was pissed.
Well, this whole tour I've been on, I've been pissed.
Yeah, haven't you? Hey, you mind getting into something sexy? I'm trying to masturbate here.
Okay.
Now, the new book is called Don't Stand Too Close to a Naked Man.
Hmm.
Do you understand that?
Because Private Parts was taken.
Yes, exactly. Well, I wanted to name my book Mein Kampf, and Simon & Schuster said no. Too many liberal Jews working there. They said it just won't work.
This title was so funny because I was with all these guys at Disney. I mean, Disney owns Hyperion, which owns this publishing company, and there's all these real serious guys at this lunch.
Yes.
And they're all going, we're thinking about using something of the act, like Home Improvement with Tim. Or Tim Improvement.
No. We know who Tim Allen is. So don't worry about it.
And I said, how about this?
Improvement.
Yeah, oh. They come up with names. It was so stupid. I said,
well,
here's the deal. I was in camp with this guy named Larry Mahoney. His advice was to all the young campers, look, just don't get too close to a naked guy.
He would say that.
He would say that. And meanwhile,
that's good advice.
Yeah, but he was a guy groping everybody.
Oh.
Well, don't say that. You don't want to get sued, do you?
No. Well, I made up a name.
You did make up a name. You're a smart man. I didn't realize. And I hit a button on you.
I
was protecting you legally.
Yes.
I said, look, this is a guy's been in trouble with the law. He don't know the laws
supposed
of this country.
You guys are supposed to be funny guys, not lawyers.
That's right.
No, I've been in trouble too much.
So that's hence naked man.
I said, this is a title that I came up with this time. Three of the guys shut, Coca-Cola through the nose. They laughed so hard. I said, now we got a title. He goes, well, it means nothing. I said, well, the book means nothing. All this is advice and how to live your life, Don't
do it. Exactly. That's all you can write. So, okay. So, but let me finish the rest of your life here. Did I do a good plug? Good. Oh, boy, these publicists drive me nuts. Oh,
they don't care about entertainment.
No,
he didn't mention the book.
He didn't mention the book. We don't care about the fact that you're entertaining an audience. We just want you to mention the book.
Sure, everybody loved him, but they won't know where he is.
Yeah, darling, I'm not Oprah, okay?
Yesterday, right in the middle of Oprah. We really had a good time.
Wait a minute. I got to ask you something. Because you did the coolest thing.
What did he do?
They bring out Bob Vila. You know, Tim came out, did his segments. And he's sitting there. They bring out Bob Vila. He does one segment with Bob Vila sitting there. And then when they come back, Oprah says, you know what? Tim has another appointment. He's going to have to leave.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Because you didn't want to sit there with Bob Vila, right?
No, that wasn't it. It was just that they asked me for three segments. I want to sit around with Bob Vila because he's been on our show. This guy is like the real thing.
Right. You know, you're the home improvement guy based on his...
Yeah. And then Oprah's in the middle, in the break. She goes, it sounds like a publicity thing. She starts dogging my publicist. She's going, this sounds like... Because right in the middle, all of a sudden, they get a letter. Tim's got to go.
Wow.
And I look around, where am I going?
Don't you feel weird? Because I did Donahue the other day, and I agreed to do three segments.
Yes.
Then right off the bat, Donahue goes, what's the matter? You can't stay for the whole show? You're afraid to confront the people of Weslaco, Texas? I go, I'm not afraid of anything. I mean, what am I going to do? So I'm there for the whole damn show, sitting there like a nut. But you do it.
He left. He got up and left.
Oh, did you get up and leave? Yeah, you're all right. Yeah, that's good.
Just turned on my tails and
you
left.
You are pissed off at the world, aren't you?
Yeah.
You're going to make them pay for those 3 years.
Oh,
you're damn right. 3 years, man. That's the most intense story. That's intense. 3 years. I mean, you must have gone nuts. But your
three
wife.
Three long years.
But your wife stayed
extra
with you.
Extra time.
Right.
She stuck with you through those 3 years. Oh, you owe your wife
did
more than I owe mine.
Did she press herself up against the glass when she got to
Yeah. Would she, like, would she get naked and, like, just press up against the glass, like, in that Turkish prison?
Yeah, but half the time it was the other guy next to me. She was doing it against.
You couldn't. She went up the wrong glass.
Yeah, wrong glass. Oh, honey, down here. This glass. Oh, I'm sorry.
So wait a second. You're telling me you didn't have sex for 3 years, so the only thing you could do was pleasure yourself.
In a fashion, yes.
Jesus Christ.
Now, are the cells open? Like, can you look through the bars at another guy?
They put you...
Hey, you mind getting into something sexy? I'm trying to masturbate here. Okay.
The first cell, you're in a big cell, a lot of guys. And then when you... This is one of the funnier stories. I called home at Thanksgiving, because once you start moving up in the hierarchy, they give you your own cell. And in prison, it's a big
deal.
That's
a big deal.
Right.
So I called home with that kind of news. Mom,
hey.
Tim, guess what? I got my own cell. Hold on. Let me tell the rest of the family. Tim got his own cell, everybody.
And gee whiz, isn't it great? All your friends are doctors and lawyers, and you got your own cell. You're an achiever.
Dave just got graduated from Michigan State. Justin Europe, and Tim's got his own cell.
And did all your friends, like, abandon you and stuff?
No. Most of my friends, my real friends, wrote it all the time.
Oh, they did?
Oh, yeah.
And were you, like, the whole time just sitting there going, wait a second. Guys who murder sometimes get out in a year.
Well, this is where...
Did you go through the whole irony?
Oh, yeah. How stupid. Plus, I met some guys in there from Texas, two guys from Texas, that sold an ounce of pot were in there 7 years.
Oh, my God.
What
about that kid in Michigan who got life?
I'm still writing this kid. I'm still working with this kid.
I've been in touch with his family and stuff.
Me too.
I'm incensed.
Well, it's because he called my family, and I was actually under the same law he was under, but I got caught in a federal crime instead of a state crime.
Right.
And so he's still in there. And
this kid's in for life, because he didn't even deal. He basically said to some guy, go over there and buy.
He was a go-between.
This is essentially what happened to me.
And they keep saying the prisons are too crowded, and yet they go after guys with dopey stuff like this.
You could actually have killed somebody and get less time than this kid's doing.
Yeah, right.
And it's ridiculous.
Yeah, I know. It's unbelievable.
But I said, politically, I got to stay away from this, because I said, somebody asked me about this book. I didn't get into it. I said, well, some of the stuff that I believe, because I'm an American sitcom,
you got to have a wholesome image and stuff.
Well, not even a wholesome, a wholesome image. I have a responsibility to my studio and everybody else. There's, four or 500 people at work because of me. And I'm not going to screw the whole thing up because I got a belief. You know, there'll be a time when I talk about it.
Yeah, after the show's off the air and you're doing Residual Heaven.
Yeah, nothing else.
Which I think is tomorrow.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you always think it's going to end.
Over tomorrow.
I always think my career is ending any day, you know what I mean? Can I say hi to you? How are you? You're a good woman. Stuck with your man. Who's that? That's your wife?
That's my wife right there.
Hey, how you doing? Can I say hi to you? How are you? You're a good woman. Stuck with your man. Oh, she don't want to talk.
Gonna start this. She's going to start this.
Oh, you have laryngitis?
Oh, yeah. Perfect. I kind of like it.
Really? Is that true?
Yeah, she does.
It's his fault?
Hey, she's acting.
Hey, bada boom.
Not bad.
Not bad. She comes in with a good
one. Well, you're a good
like
woman. You stuck with him when he was in prison. She needs my approval like a hole in the head.
Yeah, she
anyway,
care.
Tim. Congratulations on Home Improvement.
It was good to meet you, sir, by the way.
Wait a second. Let me plug your book again. The new book is called Don't Stand Too Close to a Naked Man. You can't say that
enough. Next time, this is all you have to do. You don't need Good Morning America.
Yeah, Good Morning America doesn't sell books. I hate to break the news to your publicist. It really doesn't. My show sells books. That was the fastest-selling book in Simon & Schuster history, my darling. Yes.
Yeah, look at
it. Hey, that she likes.
The book publicist that's here, which is different than the personal publicist, was here with Bill Walton. She said that every person online last time he was on was, you know, heard it on
this show.
Of course. This Good Morning America, they give you 3 minutes. That Joan London, that puppet head.
She rattles on.
She rattles on. It's like an echo in there. Oh, we have Tim Allen in here with us today. It's like a big empty head in there.
What time is my riding lesson?
That's right.
Well, remind me not to mention that to him. You know, I just talked to Howard.
2 minutes.
He's one of your biggest fans, John. Anyway.
He said your head is as empty as a puppet. Tim, a pleasure to meet you.
Nice
good luck with
you.
The show and all your success and the book. And nice to meet you, Mrs. Allen. Even though you can't talk.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you for coming in. Come back again.
I'll come back again. This is a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
As long as this guy just stays out of my face.
So, Tim, you had a really good time?
I had a really good time. This is actually a quite enjoyable experience here. Did that go all right?
It went great. It went great.
Marianne?
Mm-hmm. Please do come back.
Fun. Yeah, I'm in. I like this.
Yeah, it's fun. It's different for sure. It's not dull.